Hello friends, in this video we are going to see and develop EMF equation of a transformer. So we have seen working principle of a transformer. EMF got induced because of mutual induction, and what is the concept behind this is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So let's proceed. So I'm having a flux waveform like this. A sinusoidally varying flux waveform I will get because I'm applying a AC voltage. This is the maximum value of flux, 5m, 0, pi, 2 pi. So the equation of this waveform is phi equal to 5m sine omega t. Now this flux waveform is changing with respect to time, hence by Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, EMF induced E equal to, if I am considering windings have n number of turns, n d phi by dt. But hold on, this is just a magnitude of E. What about the direction? What do you mean by direction? Along with the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, one more law was there, and that is Lenz's law. What it says, if voltage V is give rise to a current I, because of which flux waveform or flux is getting produced, if this flux, which is changing with respect to time, linked with n number of turns, EMF will get induced such a way that it will oppose the current which has produced the flux phi. So by Lenz's law, this EMF E should be minus n d phi by dt. This is a generalized expression. We are talking in terms of primary number of turns, secondary number of turns with respect to transformer, so that I can write over here EMF induced at the primary side E1 equal to minus N1 d phi by dt, where N1 is nothing but number of turns of primary winding. So let's substitute phi equal to 5m sin omega t over here. I will get E1 equal to minus N1 d by dt of 5m sin omega t. So if I take a derivative, I will get minus N1, phi m is a constant, sin omega t derivative is cos omega t multiplied by omega. Now this E1 I can write like this, N1 phi m omega in bracket minus cos omega t. I want to write the equation of E1 in terms of a standard sinusoidal equation. So for that purpose, this minus cos theta is replaced with sin theta minus 90 degree. So theta means omega t over here. So E1 equal to phi m, omega is 2 pi f, multiplied by N1, and minus cos omega t I can write sin omega t minus 90 degree. So this is a standard equation, can be compared with E1 equal to Em1 sin omega t plus phi. I will not use the value phi because that we have already used for a flux. So this will be this symbol psi. So if I compare, I will get Em1 equal to 2 pi f into phi m into n1 and psi equal to minus 90 degree. We are dealing with the RMS value. So RMS value of EMF equal to maximum value divided by root 2. So this is equal to 2 pi f into phi m into n1 divided by root 2. If you see carefully, this 2 pi by root 2 is a constant. If you solve, that will be 4.44. So finally, what I can say, primary EMF induced RMS value is 4.44 phi m into frequency into number of primary turns. Similarly, secondary side EMF can be considered as 4.44 phi m into F into N2, because that will depends only on secondary number of turns. Flux phi will be same because EMF induced over here is because of mutual induction, and we got angle minus 90 degree with respect to flux waveform. So minus 90 means it's a lagging. So I can write a statement, E1 and E2 lag flux phi by 90 degree or pi by 2 radian. So if you draw a phasor diagram, it will be like this. Reference is flux phi, and EMF induced because of this flux phi is E1 at the primary side. So that will lag behind this phi by 90 degree. Similarly, same flux phi is linking with secondary winding. Hence, EMF2 will also lagging behind this phi by 90 degree. So here we have seen EMF equation of a transformer, and that is given by, for a primary side, 4.445 m f into n1, where n1 is a primary number of turns, e2 4.445 m into f into n2, n2 secondary number of turns. See over here, frequency f will remain same on both sides. Moreover, this e1 and e2 lag behind flux phi by 90 degree. Thank you.